drops the dice, a 5 and a 3, 6, 7, 8. Rico Abreu, the 8th place starter. He just picked up a big win at Eldora Speedway. Rico starts 8th. If he can win, you and Rico split 8 grand. That's 4 grand in your pocket. How do you feel now?
Become my new best friend.
Your new best friend. Because they're about to go racing for $25,000 here tonight, Chase. It's about to get big here at Lernerville.
Thank you. six 410 wins to his credit this season. Rico Abreu, his first career Lernerville Speedway win is a big one. The silver pack. Originally worth $25,000, but with the Durst Dice for all extra money, it'll get bumped up to $29,000. And it is official. He makes it. He's headed towards Whiskey Myers victory lane. Make his way off the front of the Massena Valley Transportation number 24 car. Gonna get a nice drink of water. Brady Forbrooks, Zach Middlebrooks.
Awesome guy.
There is Megan as well, his wife down there. And there's Gus. There to celebrate in victory lane as well. You see Ricky Warner. The work does not stop as he is down there still looking at that race car. Gets the Kubota Highlander Racing hat. Sunoco Fuels, checkered flag, and the Hoosier Tire neckband. Make his way around the front of the race car to talk to Tony DeForta.
Whiskey Myers victory lane for the fourth time in 2024 is populated by Rico Andrew! Rico Andrew just got along with his mom, Christy. She flew in from California. You were just speaking to Kendra Jacobs. Is that when you found out you were tonight's Durst Dice Roller?
Just now. That's really cool. Thank you, Phil Durst. He's going to have to dig into his pocketbooks for these ones. This is really, really cool. Just thank you to my team. They just don't give up. And in the week we had at Eldora, coming back, just keeping that confidence up. And each race, we find these little things that could make us better. So I think that's the most important thing. The chemistry builds in our team this time of year, and it's taken us a minute to get here, but this is where this team deserves to be. And Ricky Warner, Zach Middlebrooks, Brady Forbrook, they fine-tune everything, and that's what separates us, when it comes to the level of this racing. And it just, you just got to put the whole package together. So thank you to my partners, El Bandito, Yankee Tequila, Royal Jones, Rich Stadelhoff, my family. My mother's here tonight. My brother and father were at Eldora for, those four nights. And it was really just really, really special to win in front of them, just because they understand the work that gets put into these teams. And it's, it's just really, really special to be standing up here. I really was trying to minimize my mistakes. And, it's just a matter of putting yourself in position in these races. And, winning from, the second row on back's a big deal here, let alone, fourth row. So, it just shows how exciting this racing is with High Limit and the product that they're creating for sprint car racing. Just super thankful to be with a series that's so passionate about sprint car racing.
But right now, right here, make some noise for your winner, Rico Andrew! Brady Forbrook working so hard, Corey Day, there he is, Corey. A California storm on the podium here tonight at Lernerville Speedway. Your first trip here to this track in Western Pennsylvania. Before I ask you what you think of it, tell me about what you thought of the battle you had with Brad Sweet and the battle you tried to have with Rico Abreu.
Yeah, it was good. The track was dirty for that whole entire race, and then that last 10 it kind of cleaned up, and I think everyone was kind of scrambling there. There was a lot of guys running through dirty stuff in the middle, and my car was just way too free to do that. So I was around the curve basically the whole race, and lost a couple spots because of it, but knew it would come in towards the end, and it did. Just good race with Brad there, just kind of to rally back and get back around him for his second place spot, but it was hard to catch Rico. So I think we were definitely worse than a second place car tonight, so glad we established it.
When Rico makes that line change over here in 1 and 2 with inside of 4 laps to go, the very next lap you stumbled and hit the curb up at the top of the track. Did that happen because you weren't used to where his race car was, or really, how did you react to Rico changing his line so abruptly?
Yeah, actually, I followed him up there for the, I think 10 laps, and then he dove, and I just kind of didn't have my mark right. I was kind of judging off his race car where I needed to enter, and, his race car wasn't there that lap, so, yeah, I stumbled. I wish I could go back and do 10 things different that race, but I'm still on the podium.
I'll do 10 things different. I can.